Good evening, and it's great to have you with us here on this Wednesday night, and it's great to begin with promising news for a change. The news today on the Johnson & Johnson one-shot vaccine. The new 62-page report from the FDA out today saying the one-shot vaccine is safe and effective. Emergency use authorization could now come within days. Those welcome numbers tonight, the vaccine is 86% effective at preventing severe illness here in the U.S. and 100% effective at preventing hospitalizations and deaths. And at least 70% effective against asymptomatic spread, when you have no symptoms, when you don't even know you have it. If we can halt that, we can reduce transmission. It comes after Pfizer said just yesterday that it will meet that deadline by the end of the July, 300 million doses, and Moderna saying 300 million doses by the end of July, too. That would be enough for all Americans. And all of that was without the news from Johnson & Johnson tonight. So this evening, what does this all mean for the timeline? Could vaccinations happen sooner, even if it's just weeks sooner? And we're tracking more FEMA vaccination sites opening just today. This one in Queens, New York, aiming to administer 3,000 shots a day. This one in Houston tonight, hoping for 6,000 shots a day. So this evening, what you need to know about this new one-shot vaccine and how soon could we see it? Dr. Jha standing by, and ABC's Eva Pilgrim leading us off.
Tonight, just days away from potential emergency use authorization, the U.S. is now likely on the verge of a third vaccine, and this time a single dose, and the news is promising. New analysis today finding the Johnson & Johnson one-dose vaccine safe and effective. 86% effective for preventing severe illness in the U.S. alone, and 100% effective in preventing hospitalizations or deaths. Another key finding, the report saying the single-dose vaccine may also prevent some asymptomatic disease when you don't even know you have it, which means it could help reduce the spread of the virus.
Preliminary analysis suggests that the vaccine provides a 74% protection against asymptomatic disease, which is important because if you can prevent asymptomatic disease, then you will also reduce transmission.
The FDA saying the vaccine had the expected side effects like fever and fatigue, but no reports of severe allergic reactions.
Overall, the vaccine provides very robust protection throughout the world, including against the worrisome viral variants.
So what does this mean for the vaccine supply in the U.S.? Johnson & Johnson says it could have 3 to 4 million doses sent out next week. It could have 100 million doses by the summer. Pfizer and Moderna already promised enough doses for all Americans by the end of July. So this newest vaccine could simply add to that supply. The U.S. could actually have a surplus, enough for 400 million people by midsummer.
The prospect of a potential third approved vaccine is very encouraging and will help to increase the overall vaccine supply, which will allow more Americans to get access to getting vaccinated sooner.
And tonight, news for the thousands of so-called long haulers, COVID victims who still have symptoms months later. The National Institutes of Health has announced an official study into long haulers after a recent study found about one-third of COVID patients followed reported lingering symptoms as long as 9 months after being sick.
An important part of this would be to design therapeutic approaches, hopefully, by medications that we already have. We just need to know how to use them.
It is important that we stay focused on those long haulers. In the meantime, let's get right to Eva Pilgrim back with us again tonight. And Eva, we've all been sort of learning as we go here. And usually when the FDA issues these reports on these new vaccines, then the panel meets a day or two later, and then the green light, emergency use authorization, usually follows. So how soon are we thinking?
Well, David, it's not guaranteed, but all signs are it's a go as early as Friday. And the Biden administration says as soon as it's green-lighted, it's ready to go. 3 to 4 million doses could be shipped out next week. David?
Eva Pilgrim leading us off tonight. Eva, thank you.